Hey language learners, today I want to talk to you about Toggl. Toggl is a tool that we use with all of our coaching clients here at Refold, and they love it. Time tracking is a great way to get insight into your own immersion and your personal learning systems, and have a concrete way to look at your own progress. It's also a completely free tool, and so I'm making this video to show you how you can get started with Toggl to have a nice simple tool across all your devices to track your own immersion time. The actual tool is made for teams that are tracking work hours, so there's more features that we can just ignore as language learners. And the best part is that it's completely free for an individual to use. I'm gonna quickly show you my Toggl that I've been using for almost a year and a half at this point. Then I'll show you how you can set a new account for your immersion and get it onto your mobile devices. So this is what my Toggl looks like. There's just this almost cascading sheet of everything that I've been doing. There's a bunch of little things on the side over here, and then the main input area is right up here at the top. You can just scroll down and see all the things that you've been doing over the past several weeks. Mine is very simple. I've mostly just been reading and doing my flashcards recently. You can also look at your reports and you can see what you've done over this year, over last year. There's so much information here that you can really gain a lot and learn a lot of interesting information about yourself and your own habits, and have a bit more control over your immersion. It also creates these lovely little graphs to give you insight that you can share with other immersion learners or your friends. You can see detailed complete lists of exactly when you've been immersing and all these lovely information. You can even download it all in a CSV format and do what you will with spreadsheets and graphs like that. Let's jump over to a brand new browser so I can show you how you could set up your own brand new Toggl. Here I am at track.toggl.com. And since on this browser I'm not logged in, it's gonna ask me to either create an account or log in. So I'm going to go down to sign up for free, and I'm going to choose to sign up with Google because it's fast and easy. I'll use my brand new My Refold Immersion account. It will redirect, build everything, and ba-boom. You can ignore this. I'm gonna walk you through exploring on your own. So, done. First thing I'll mention, like I said earlier, it is completely free. So it says you're on a trial for 29 days. You can just ignore that. You don't need any of the paid features to use this as a fully functional tracking tool. I don't like the week view, so I'm going to go to the list view. Okay, so there's nothing tracked yet. So let's start building some projects, which are going to be the main buckets that you put your different time into. So I'm going to go down to projects and I'm going to hit new project. I'm going to call this extensive immersion. Remember, this is when you're just spending a ton of time with the language, and I'll do this in green, a little dark, nice dark green. You can ignore the client part and keep it private and then create project. I'm going to do this for priming, interactive immersion, extensive immersion, and output. You're welcome to bucket your learning into whatever way makes the most sense for you, but these are the different buckets that we use with our coaching clients, and so that's what I'm going to stick with here. Now that we have our projects, we can go back to the timer here, and we can put in something. I like to just put a generic name for what I'm doing, such as reading, and then you can click here and choose what bucket it goes into, so this is extensive immersion. I'm gonna turn off billable here. This is for if you're getting paid for the kind of work that you're tracking. You can completely just ignore it, and then you just hit the little play here. I'm gonna immediately stop it at 1 second because I'm actually not doing immersion right now. But to make things easier, I'm going to add several different items in the list at 1 second each so that you can use the shortcut to continue something by clicking on this little play right there to do it again. Okay, so now I've input a bunch of different activities that you could be doing throughout your immersion. This is not an exhaustive list. This is just a bunch of different things that I had off the top of my head. So now the great thing about Toggl is that there's this line over here that you can just click the play button to immediately start that thing that you're doing. It'll put in the correct project and the name of whatever you're doing. So let's say I was about to start doing Anki reviews for the day, so I could just click continue time entry. And it just starts it right away. It's ticking up, duh, duh, duh. And then you hit stop whenever you're done. And then it adds it together. There's a little two here, which says that there's two times you've done that today. And that's essentially how it works. You can just click start when you want to start and stop when you want to stop. If you forgot to track something and you want to retroactively add it to your pool, you can hit this little plus up here or click M on the keyboard, and it will bring you into a manual mode where it says, what have you done in the past? You can choose any of your previously done things. Let's say I had an italki session that I forgot to track. So I put it in there, it automatically puts my project, and I just choose when I started. So I started at 10 o'clock on the nose, and it ended just about now. And then I hit the little plus and it adds it. Boom, right there, italki session, and it puts it lower on the list because it happened about 40 minutes ago in the day. You can switch between manual mode and tracking mode. And those are the basics of Toggl. If you want to get fancy, there's things called tags where you can mark maybe the actual show you are watching or the actual book you're reading. I personally never use tags just because it adds an extra layer that I don't really want to keep track of when I'm doing my Toggl. Now, this is a brand new account, so you're not going to see much, but if you can go over to reports and look at various different things about your immersion, you can see all the different tasks grouped up into the buckets, see how much you've done each of them, the percentage, you get a little graph here, and you can look at last week, this week, whatever it might be, and understand a lot more about the immersion that you're doing and feel good that your number is going up, even if you don't necessarily feel like you're getting better at the language. You are, I promise you are, but watching your number go up is great. Let's look at some of the additional add-ons you can use to make tracking easier. The first one is getting the extension in the top of your browser to track without having to go to the main site. So if I go to the Chrome Web Store, and I search Toggl, there it is, boom. Add to Chrome, add extension, it's been added. I will have to log in. Oh, hello. So I'll pin it. I'll have to log in. Oh no, it's already logged in for me. And so you see all your things here. You can just immediately click on the play for, let's say I'm doing some audiobook listening right now, and it starts playing up there. I can even close these, have a brand new tab open with nothing going on, and then I can just click up here and hit stop, and done. So it's super easy to add to your browser and do things right away from there. Now I'm gonna hop over to my phone and show you what the app can look like, all the way from logging in to syncing everything and getting it all up and running. All right, so here I am in the TogglTrack app, and I'm going to log in with Google the same way that I logged in on my computer. And syncing data, boom. There's everything that we added via the desktop app. So I'm gonna click up here on the hide because I don't like these suggestions. I like just having the full list. And this is essentially the same thing as the desktop app, but condensed down and with an extra Pomodoro option if you like to study that way. So whenever you want to start a task, all you have to do is click on the little play button right under the number. Let's say we're doing Anki reviews. Hit the play button, it starts in the bottom here. You can swipe up to bring up more information about it. You can see when you started, the bucket it's in, everything like that. And then as soon as you're done, you just the stop. That's all there is. You're going to accidentally start timers sometimes. The easiest thing to do is just to swipe up and then delete time entry, so you don't have to worry about it. And honestly, that's the bulk of the entire mobile app. It's much harder to look at your stats on the mobile version, so I highly recommend going to the web version. And if you want to retroactively add things, so manual mode, there's this plus in the top where you put in what you did, and then the project that it would go into just right there. If you want to change any settings, there's plenty of little things to play around with, including the clock format and whatever it might be. Your Pomodoro settings are all in here, and also how it syncs together. But I'm not going to go through that right now. The last thing I want to show is, on iOS at least, you can set up automation so that it automatically tracks how long you spend in certain apps. I have not found a way to do this on Android, regrettably, but it's very easy to set up on iOS. So if that applies to you, keep watching. If not, there's a times code on the screen that you can skip to. So if you search shortcuts, you can open up shortcuts on your phone, and then go to the automation tab at the bottom. You'll see that I already have one example set up. When I open Kindle it'll start tracking, and then when I close it, it'll stop it again. So to add one of these for yourself, you can hit the plus up here, personal automation, scroll down to app, and then you have to choose is opened or is closed. That's the trigger event. And you choose what it does, you choose what app it's looking for. Let's say Anki in this case. Done, next, and now we have to tell it what to do when you open Anki. So we put in toggle track, boop, and then you hit start time entry. You'd have to choose what it's called. So I'd say Anki reviews and is in priming. And it's so that it sets the bucket for you and everything. And you hit next. Make sure to turn ask before running off because you don't want it to bother you every time you open Anki. So it just automatically starts in the background. Done. And then you have to add one for when you close it. Personal automation, app is closed. Anki, done. Next, add action, toggle, and stop time entry, done. And that's it. That's your automation setup. So every time this phone opens up the Anki app, it'll start tracking, and when I close it, it'll stop again. Easy as pie. Remember, you can use this tool in whatever way makes the most sense for you. I personally don't track every little bit of immersion that I do anymore. I only track the ones that are nice and easy when I'm sitting at my computer doing something or I'm reading on my phone because I have that automation set up. And so you can mold this to fit your own personal learning style and habits. As you build up more track time, I'd love to see your graphs posted in the Refold Central Discord server, which you can join at refold.link/join. And you can also let me know if you have any questions. I hope you enjoyed this short Refold tutorial. And happy immersing!